Well, we made her! Except the races are already postponed till tomorrow, which sucks. But anyways, we made her to King Carden. This is where we're staying for the night, and actually the races are about 3.5 hours northwest of us. No, I'm just kidding. About 30 minutes west of us here, or north of us here. So, but anyways, I see a sailboat. That guy is probably going to want to maybe come in fairly soon, I would think, because it's getting... I can't keep her still with you guys rolling around in the back here. But anyways, we're going to stop for some lunch, and then I don't know what we're going to do after that. We've got a little bit till we can actually check into our room for tonight, so... I got to charge the camera for a bit while I'm having lunch, and then we'll go check out the sights. Not you, buddy. Get out of the way. Really? Holy. All right, just to give an idea where we are, we actually live a little bit north of the Guelph little circle there, and then to the right a hair bit. So we drove all the way over here to Lake Huron, King Carden here. And that is pretty well where we are right now. So I'm actually looking this way out into the water. But anyways, it's a bit of sand down there, but it's a lot of stone. It's really neat. A lot of fossils and stuff. So let's head her down and have a look. So this lake is called Lake Huron. And if you swam over this way a whole whack, you'd be in the Michigan. Good old Michigan. So about halfway out there is where the divider line thingy is for the US-Canada side. And it's not really a super well-kept beach like the Wasega Beach is. Like, they don't groom this one. It's just all natural. So, you know, we got a bit of sand, and now we're getting into a bit of drifty wood sticks and some sand and Rockies and more rocks and more rocks, and all of a sudden you're into like a heaps of rocks. Big drop down here. And pretty much, you know, the whole way along, right? So she's pretty rocky, stony, rocky beach. Now the other one we're going to is called Sauble Beach, and it's actually way up the coast here yet. And it's actually like a beach, if you know what I mean. But lots of really cool rocks here. If you're in there looking at rocks, man, spend all days here, I'll tell you that one. But, and then there's like this little rocky island out here with a bunch of somethings on them. Not sure what kind of birds those are. I can't hold her still enough. I don't know what they are, but anyways. Yeah, rock. And just up the road here was a bit of a marina, but we didn't go into that. It said sort of like private and crap, so I'm like, okay, whatever. But anyways, just give you a little taste of this water edge. And we're going to let the kids play in the little park there for a bit and then head right. Oh, there's a big one. Great big mothers. Here comes a good one. I almost surfed that one. Oh, it almost got me. So anyways, we're going to head her out soon. So this was kind of cool. They have all this boardwalk all the way along here, and they've got these people, I guess, sponsored money or whatever to build it. And they've put their names in. So... this is all like Lions Club members here, but down further was like Sobeys, like the grocery stores, and a bunch of things. So, yeah, this is must have been done by the Lions Club or something. A lot of lions in here, I guess. Holy. There's an in memory of. I don't know if you can see that, in memory of. And now we're into some more names, another in memory of. It's kind of a neat way to do it. 20 years, what is this going to look like, you know? Like, it's going to be all gone to crap. They're going to have to redo it again. So maybe they'll get more donations and redo it. So kind of a good idea, though. These ones here looks like they're maybe new ones. Or somebody wanted to sponsor one or something. And, well, we got some available over here. These look like new ones. So there you go. That's what happens. Well, we've been driving lots today. We're going to fire up here, see if the engine light stays on.
Off.
Oh, look at that. Sweet! I think we might have cured it. But now it's telling me I gotta change my engine oil. Actually, I just added a liter. Oh well. I guess it's a double-double on the roof. Double-double. I don't think he's actually leaving. just letting up there to get maybe cooled off. Well, just going for a tour. We're just about to go under all the hydro power lines that pretty much power all sort of our area and north and south and Toronto and all this stuff. There's a great big nuclear plant. If you kept following those lines that way. So there's a million bazillion towers and stuff up there. They've slapped in a whole bunch of these windmill towers too now. So trying to offset the nuclear, I guess, a little bit. I don't know. And yeah, there's a bazillion of them like our place. Those hydro, whatchamacallem deweys, windmill deweys all over the place. Hey, we made it to Sobel Beach, if you can see that. Well, we're just not really going to the beach. We're just gonna take a little drive through, but sort of why we came up here, but there's a big thunderstorm on the way, so no racetrack tonight, no racing tonight, which is Saturday night tonight. You guys won't see this until I get home, of course, but they've rescheduled it, postponed it till tomorrow at 2. So that kind of sucks. But anyways, we're going to head her in here and have a look at the beach. Holy crap. I can tell there's probably going to be a whack load of people here by the looks of things. Still, don't walk out with your kid hanging out. What is he yelling about?
Well, you can't videotape.
So, I can still drive. I can multitask. How do you know it wasn't just hooked onto a tripod? That's a problem.
It was shaped like a hand.
Nut and fudge. I wonder if they're allergic to nuts in there. So, I have no idea where to go here. But somewhere.
Continue on Shore Road, South Beach.
Well, I'm trying. It's busy, little lady. It's a little wavy in here tonight. Welcome to Sobel Beach. Holy crap, look at the peoples. Look at the peoples. That is insane. Okay, you gotta stop there, bud. Give bowl or seriously a bowling alley here?
In 250 meters, arrive at 226 to 398
Shore
Road, South Beach.
Oh, ow, looks like the tide's come in. Absolutely no charcoal barbecues. Because they don't want you barbecuing.
Well, we could do some good skin here, it's nice and sandy.
Yeah, you might not like that too much. No dogs allowed in beach, sorry deal, you have to stay in the truck. Well, let's go down and have a look at these waves. It's a little more wavier area here. Oh, I got to park here because it's SFN29. SFN29 containers here. See? 29? Got to park here. Well, this is actually a road here. They call this, I think, Sandy Beach Road or something. And I didn't think they'd actually let you drive along here, but apparently they do. They're driving down there. Sweet. It's actually hard too, but it's really wet. This is surprising. Well, there's the clouds that have canceled our racing for tonight. You can see it's nice sort of there, and then it comes, and then it's coming from this way down. So kind of crappy, but some nice waves coming in. Wavy. Very wavy. That'd be the surf coming up a little bit from the wetter coming in, I would imagine. But this is a totally different lake than what I'm used to, so I have no idea. No idea what's going on here, but she looks a little wavier than normal. That I'm used to anyways. Gonna try something here. I'm gonna focus in real close and then watch as the wave comes through, and then to watch the sand get washed down after. How close I can get here. I just need a good wave. Come on, wave. Come on, wave. Oh, sure. Now that I focus in, there's a good one. Look at it wash it all up and down, eh? That would suck to be a grain of sand, I think. Oh, here comes some big waves. sick yet? There, that might make her a little better. Well, you can sure tell the ones from the city. Hold up my pants. Oh, that's funny. It's like really cold. This lake is like super cold. This lake influences the weather a lot with the cold and the warm air and stuff. Lots of fun. Oh, I almost got it. I almost got it. How's it going, eh? Does your friend not say nothing? Apparently not.
Are you shy?
Anything more than hello?
Hello.
Do you dance?
Yeah, I'm dancing, I'm dancing.
Can we give you some music? You dance?
Really loud.
Itchy, don't you know? Look at the size of them finger-breaking beaks on them things, eh? Holy, that's why it says there, do not touch, we bite. We will eat you for lunch.
Hello.
This is my fleas are bad.
It's coming.
Hello? Hello?
Can you dance?
No, he said no.
He says no. Not
is
to that
shy?
Music. As soon as I shut the camera off, you're going to say all kinds of stuff, aren't you?
Ready?
Nothing.
He's looking at us going, you idiots.
Yeah, she's gonna see this every day. Well, that's it for Sauble Beach. We just took a little tour up the main drag. Seen some back ends of some girls that I wasn't really... Kind of made me feel sick in my stomach, if you know what I mean. Ooh. Ooh. I would have put the camera on, but no, I thought I better not. You guys might have gone, bleh, too, so... I feel kind of sick in my stomach.
You did eat a lot.
I did eat a lot too, so not too much for dinner maybe, but anyways, we're gonna head her down this beach road. It takes us down to the south end of Sauble Beach, so we're gonna head her down. Okay, so back on the tripod arm. I'm not even looking at my camera, so that guy obviously does not understand I was yelling at me, but anyways, whatever, it's his problem. Oh, some people do need to wear a shirt too. No, I'm not the smallest guy either, but I don't go around advertising myself, kind of thing. But whatever, that's fine. It's up. It's up. That's up to him. It's up to him. Up to him. Nothing to do with me. I guess maybe we're not going down through here.
We could go mud bogging.
Oh.
No, no.
Uh-huh. Oh boy.
Let's do it.
Why is this so high?
Don't turn around.
This isn't four-wheel drive, Dale.
I think it's not.
Oh?
Why is there water sitting here? I don't really understand that. Well, nice knowing you, boys.
These are getting out to push.
That was awesome. Freaking awesome.
That was awesome.
Oh, that scared the crap right out of me. Remember I said I was feeling sick before? Yeah, it's all in my shorts now. Oh, still running though. Woo!
You better just keep it running, girl.
Go truck.
I'm surprised it didn't stall, yeah.
Yeah, we're good. GM, who doesn't do that? It's not a Chrysler. Oh, I just spilled something there, didn't I? Well, this guy in this Ford Explorer can do her. I can do her too. I think that's a Ford Explorer.
Is the back full of water, Allie?
There's a lot come up over the hood though. Oh boy. Yeah, I guess these are runoff deweys. Probably from the streets up there. They probably just pipe right down there and away they go. So that was cool.
That was awesome. You're just
rocking your window.
Oh, this is pretty rough road through here though. Oh, it's blocked off down there again too, I think. Oh
man, yes. Back through it.
We won't be getting through that. But we shall see here. How the heck are all these other people getting down here though? That's what I don't get. There's a bus down here. Bus wouldn't have gone through that. Must be another exit driveway somewhere. The bus definitely wouldn't have gone through that big puddle. Holy crap.
It wasn't there before.
A lot of these washed out thingies here from the whatchamacallums. Oh man, it's getting rougher too.
Well, we got a whole barbecue set up there. Let's just go ask them for dinner.
Yeah, really, eh? Just yeah.
It's not allowed up here on the beach.
Oh, no, maybe charcoal. We can still get down through here. Cool. Well, somehow this bus got down here, so I don't know. What's this guy doing here? I gotta watch this guy in this truck thing here.
Oh, that's not deep.
That was not as deep as the other one, I don't think.
Well,
how did the bus get down here then? That bus wouldn't have done that, I don't think. Holy. I don't know why all the water's sitting there, though. It's really weird. Good way to wash off the car. That's nice and clean. Oh boy. Rednecks. We can make it through here. It actually does come out down here.
That guy could be aiming for the water.
I still don't know how that bus got down here.
Maybe the water wasn't there when you came.
Maybe he's gonna have a hard time getting out of here now. Or maybe they got a big dump of rain here just like this afternoon because everything does look kind of wet. Oh.
Does the water look wet?
The water is wet. Maybe that guy's still there because he doesn't know how he's gonna get out now. But yeah, this does. Oh, I can sand all over my windshield now. That's not good on the scraping on the window. Hear it. Oh,
he's gonna go back through it.
He's looking at me like, you're freaking nuts, bud! Yeah, well...
Awesome.
Gotta be one to know one. Nuts. Probably was better along the actual beach than this part was.
You would probably be able to do some pretty good donuts.
No.
Not with all these people, like, just lollygagging right up the middle of the road. I should actually be way over here, not where these knobs are sitting. I don't understand this. This must have just done maybe all washed out today or something. That guy went through that bicycle on this one, alright, so.
Yeah.
Bud, have you got your shorts on? Okay, I really don't want to know that.
Yeah, he had red shorts on.
Yeah, you could just bicycle straight towards me. Noob. That would be kind of hard riding on this stuff, I think.
Yeah, just give her when the back tires come.
Give her?
Yeah. Now.
Yeah, I can work. Oh, you hear that weird noise up there now.
Yeah, it's probably all on the belts and stuff. It's probably all wet.
Yeah, I don't think it's the end of this beach.
Oh, it does end eventually, yeah.
It would be awesome coming through here with a dirt bike.
Sounds funny now. He made me do it.
I didn't make you do it. You're driving.
But your CAA will pep me up out here.
And the car is dead at home.
Well, you did that yourself.
Yeah, Allie defeated all the way.
Allie did it.
You left it in!
Okay, enough fighting. We're doing mud bogging here.
And the tiniest I've ever seen.
Ooh. Ooh, I don't know how that guy's gonna get through in that car.
That's gonna be like over his car.
That sounds like the idle will probably squeal in a little bit there. Squealer in. Okay, this does come out here, I'm sure. It's a long road, but it's down in there somewhere.
You aim towards the puddle, Daddy.
South Beach Road. No. I think that's enough for trying to get her too wet. Oh, these are really rough here.
Oh. Deep enough in the park.
Yeah, but I really don't want to walk back an hour. If you know what I mean?
Walking back would be more than an hour. Wait, we missed our pool.
So I still don't know how all these people got down here. Maybe there's a road there, actually. Where'd that come from? Get out of the way, seagull! Hello! Jeez.
They've been real well fed today.
Nerdy.
And again. Yep.
Is that a road there? Oh, it is, too. That's one of the shacks, like, up at the front there. Hi! Oh, I should have splashed through that one. He would have loved that. I would have had like a Jeep or something, but not this thing. Better not do that anymore. It doesn't sound too good. Have to get her going on the highway and get her dried out. But anyways, looks like we're clear. Oh, can't believe it's still driving. Oh well. Let's go. Well, welcome to Sunday. Yes, our race was postponed last night. Apparently they got a huge major thunderstorm up Sauble Raceway last night, Sauble Beach area, which is about an hour northwest of us here, where we stayed. But we're at the Holiday Inn Express here in King Carden, and we just finished breakfast. We're just packing up, and we're going to head her, I guess, back up to the beach area for a little while, because the races are postponed until today, Sunday, and they don't start till 2 o'clock, so we got a little bit of time to kill. But anyways, yeah, so we're on second floor here. Pretty sweet. See my rig parked way over there. Hopefully it starts after getting swamped last night. That was pretty cool, but anyways, should hopefully be all right. It ran home fine, so. Anyways, pack up and let's get at her. Well, just going to check the swamping edge. It looks like we got her up pretty good last night. It's all been wet and crappy up in here and stuff, and stuff's still kind of sort of damp, so hopefully she'll start up for us and away we go. Hopefully. Well, here we go. Fingers crossed. Oh, yeah. All right, so we're just touring along here, sort of making our way up to the racetrack. It's really foggy and crappy on. I don't know if they're going to go today or not. That sucks, but anyways. I'd stop here. Look at this bike. This thing is so cool. Let's go look. Oh, maybe that's what I need on my bike. Oh, this is so funny. It's even got school bus lights on her. School bike. Do not pass when signal's flashing. That is pretty cool, Dilly. What do you think?
That's
cool. So I could drive us and you guys could all sit back there and go to school. You getting on?
Sure.
Okay, you can even steer it. It's an old Yamaha. Don't know what size engine. Okay.
I'll get the one back here.
Here we go. Clutch is a little stiff, but other than that, she seems okay. CB radio. I don't know what that is. Computer leveling air suspension system. Boy, oh boy, this was a deluxe unit. Holy. This is pretty neat. 40,000, almost 41,000 kilometers on them.
Three more people on here.
You coming, Peanut? Oh, what's a matter, Peanut? This is pretty cool. I like this. That's probably where your gas goes. It's probably a long time ago seizured up. But yeah, someone put a bit of work into this just to make her a school bus. This is probably, oh, it even still works. Probably one of these things here if you had a battery on it. But we don't have a battery, so that is pretty cool. Oh, now you're on. Grump face. Holy. Oh, grump face. Oh, it's not a school bike. It's a cool.
Stinky bike.
That is pretty cool. There it says there it's a 1300, I think. 1300cc. Holy cow. Someone's actually put a lot of work into that, you know that? Because there's welding been done on there. And I don't know. That's pretty cool. Saddlebags. Oh, I can even get into them still. Holy shnikes. That is really cool. Oh, and this open too? Oh, it does. It's even wired. Holy crap. Just need a battery.
And then we can go.
Can you imagine what the cops would say this going down the road? I don't know if they could do anything about it if it was licensed and insured and all that cool stuff. But I think this is just a dummy setup here. I don't think it actually would drive, but you never know. You never know. It's got pipes on it, so it does have a drive shaft under there I can just sort of see. Holy shnikes, that is cool. Well, guess what? We are actually going home. Believe it or not, I am so freaking pissed off. Oh, just after we looked at the motorcycle there, we went and did one other little stop. I'm like, wow, these brakes feel funny again. Sure enough, that one brake line that feeds the two on the back which I looked at and I thought I should have probably done, but it wasn't done that long ago. It should be fine. Yeah, well, it blew. Not too happy. And nowhere up here on a Sunday is open for automotive service. So it's like, really? There's Canadian Tires. I've been to two Canadian Tires. One wasn't even open, like the auto parts part, the auto section. The other one was open, but oh, it's only tires and oil changes, and that's it. I'm like, wow, really? No other garages. Everything's closed up here on Sunday, so that blows. So we're going to try to limper home, and I don't know. But anyways, hopefully we'll make our life. Holy frig, we made her home. What a completely stressful ride that was. Oh, man. Ah, I feel like switching the brake line on this with a freaking backhoe and the thumb, you know that? Ah, by the way, I said, it's only a brake line. Yeah, I know. Freaking brake lines. Holy crap. Right to the floor. The whole bloody way right to the floor. Just totally pissed you right off. Anyways, let's have a quick look here. I think we're going to head her out again. Well, she's up under there somewhere. It's gone all squishy and crappy on us. Stupid freaking thing. What a pain in the nuts that is. Holy frig, we actually made it. No, that's where they go for the cars, I guess, for, I don't know. I have no idea. I've never been here before. But yeah, I guess this one would work too. Oh man, I can't believe we made her. That's a lot of friggin' driving today. We still gotta get home yet too. It's gonna suck. Oh well. Well, we made her. We do have pit passes, but I don't know if we're gonna really bother going in here. I can pretty well see it all from here. But anyways, over here's the car, sitting there in a rock. Looking good. And a couple more of them there, of course. This guy, they must be getting ready, so I guess we made her. Oh man, what a rush, I am so upset. But anyways, we're here. Well, this isn't the race, but this is that race. Standing right up in the corner up there, and I was just a little nervous about that, so that's him there. Oh, okay, sorry, I got the wrong car. He's in the last car guy here, Rick's car, Rick Lamar's car. See him here in a sec. I'll maybe film this race for you. That's him there. So this track would be a 1 mile, quarter mile track. know if he got him or not. Well, it's caution.
Oh, that's weird.
Sweet, they even got the little mini cars here. Mini race cars, that's awesome.
First time out and four-time feature winner this year. That's Nolan Quinton out of Orangevale for Hyde Web Heating and Air Conditioning, Can Do Homes, McKinnon Transport, Stage It With Style, and GT Travel. 34 Heating and Cooling, Pickney's Retail, Beefway Meats, Paradigm Homes, Construction, and White Designs.
9 horsepower these
days. We're going to race 10 laps here.
On the lawnmowers.
Winner earlier was 51 Nolan Quinton, who's got his share of wins so far in 2014. Trent Barth, top driver for most of the year, 2 years ago here at Sauble Speedway, had a collision with Ty Cavlin up on number 4 and went out for the rest of the year with a severe concussion. Came back last year and hoping for a win here today. Looking for the green flag, coming off of 4, down the front. Tyler's got the green and we're racing.
Ah, sounds like a high-powered lawnmower now.
Hoffman racing with the number 37 out front, Eric Tom. 12 is Boston. Look out, folks. Here comes that number 51, Nolan Quinton. A very dominant car here in 2014. And Quinton's going to try and take the lead on lap one. He's got it by about half a bumper. It's Quinton in 51, Tom in 37, Hasty in 34, Trent Bach in 12, and Parker in 8. Nolan Quinton with the lead. He's got a whack of wins this year. Quinton 51, leading him around. In second spot, 34, Alex Hasty. And in third, the 37 of Eric Tom. Number 12 is Trent Boff in fourth. And fifth is Kyle Parker in 8. Last chance, folks, to get your 50-50 tickets. Last chance. By the size of the crowd today, we're looking at a big 50-50. 2 weeks ago, $1,015 to the winner. 51 Quinton out front. Halfway, 4 down, 4 to go. It is Quinton in 51, Hasty in 34, Eric Tom in 37, and 12, Trent Bach. Number 8 is Kyle Parker.
But he's almost got to have a lap on
once
him.
Again, and this one is the 51 of Nolan Quinton. Quinton's looking good. Hasty in second. Tom in third. Bob in fourth.
They're probably about
and
your age,
Kyle
Parker,
the rookie driver,
they're probably about your age.
Years old. He is back there in fifth spot. Two laps to go. Two remaining. Nolan Quinton looking for his second win of the afternoon.
His poor guy in the end.
And he's got a whole bunch of checkered flags this year. Hasty, Tom, Bach, and Parker. The white flag is out. One lap to go. Final lap.
No loser on this one, bud.
51, Nolan Quinton, down the back chutes. He's putting it down there about 60 miles an hour. These 9 horsepower can go up to about 60. And Nolan Quinton is coming in. He'll get the purple flag. Quinton wins it. For a second, it'll be closer. It's going to be the 34 of Alex Hasty.
Nice.
Followed by 37 of Eric Tom, 12 Trent Bach, and number 8, Kyle Parker.
Where's Urban Warfield? Cherry Bus Lines, Hanna and Hamilton Construction, Lithgow, Township Glass and Body Casting of Orangeville, Anonymous, Kick and Colon Cancer's Butt, BILLSTMAXX from Liverpool, Murray Crimp of Moorfield, Josh Grunt's Racing, Plowboys Racing with 747.
Right now that is Julia. She's got the boxes there. She is Rick Walter's sister.
Yeah.
one in a wire pin on Ontario. Jumper Dark Side release McNeil Motorsports is Adam Adams. The 23 out of initial jumper wired out loud.com is Paul Miller. The 7 is Brenton Plain Jumper Home Hardware Building Center of Bowman Belvedo Graphics and Fender Construction 91N for Millennium Training Service.
Thank you.
Rick's sister is with us. That's her down in the blue. His brothers, Mark.
And it's been like old hat. I think I've interviewed you. I probably talked to you more often than Dwight at the time. Again, woman. I don't know where this is good. There we go. Another Rick Woolner Memorial win, but this 8-car victory lane looks like it was on rail.
Oh man, you guys worked hard all day. You know, we kind of tossed a bunch of setups at it. We changed springs, we changed shocks, we changed tires, we changed every geometry measurement you could change. And we really hit on top of the pitcher. Based off the heat races, you know, the car was good. We hadn't put the good tires on it yet, but once we put the tires on and the changes we made, man, it just comes to life. That's the best I've ever had a car here.
Now, I mean, the race moved was Barney last year. I mean, Sauble, another place to modify and Rick Woolner race. I mean, and this is his old chassis. I mean, it's got a lot of mean a lot to you and car owner Greg Gibson to put this 8 victory.
Oh, yeah, big time. You know, there's really not much left of the original car to consider it really Rick's, but it's there in spirit. And, you know, we like to come out to this race, and we put a lot of effort into it to honor the guy because he's, you know, good guy, good racer, and it kind of honors all good racers that come before, too.
Once again, thank all of you. Awesome for you, Gary.
Well, you couldn't do this deal without the crew. My car owner, crew chief, head guy, Greg, is still in St. Eustache, Canadian Tire car. He's on his way back. You know, they had a good night. Great for them last night. They won. The rest of the crew, you know, got the dad. I didn't think he was going to make it here all week because he's been in the hospital, but he persevered, got out the day before yesterday and came anyway. It's all good. Then we get Buddy Ken there that's always working on it, Brother Derek, Brother Dean. My boy Eric's out here helping. That's the main thing that makes this car go around. You know, I'm this lucky guy that gets to sit in the seat. But other than that, I'd like to thank the sponsors. We have no official sponsors on our car, but, you know, we'd like to thank the people at Hand on the Holidays. You know, they make the series possible. Great group, and everybody else here that, you know, has put their name on a lap this weekend after the Rick race. You know, that's a big deal to us, and we really appreciate it.
Kevin, give it up for you. Rick Woolner Memorial Champion, Gary McLean.
Well, racing's over. We've been racing all the way home. Holy frick, I am so sick of driving. That's a lot of driving this weekend. I'll try to tally it roughly in my head when we get home. But anyways, heading home here, some nice, great big clouds. Tornado Sunday. All right. Holy. Anyways, a few more minutes. We'll be finally home. I'm so freaking wasted. Not drunk wasted. I'm so freaking tired. So from here to Sauble Beach, we'll say. No, we didn't go right to Sauble Beach the first night. We went to King Cardin, which was a little bit closer. Was about 2 hours. So we went from here. Yes, I don't remember when. The first trip from here to King Cardin was about 2 hours, and then we toured around there a little bit, and then we went up to Sauble Beach that night. So from King Cardin to Sauble Beach, that was about an hour, and then home again. And then we came from, well, we went home then back to King Cardin for where we were staying at the Holiday Inn there. And then we came back on the way up to Sauble to the racetrack, and then the freaking brake line blew. So we went from there and drove all the way back. I stopped at the one Canadian Tire to get some brake fluid just in case, because I knew I was going to run her dry. And then, like, yeah, I got halfway home, I got no brakes at all, which is really bad. So I thought, well, we'll just drive all the way home again. But before we left, I thought maybe the Canadian Tire at there was two there on the route from Sauble Beach back to King Cardin. But anyways, I stopped at the one. They had an auto center, not even open. So it's like, okay, well, that's no good. So we went all the way back to King Cardin. I'm like, oh, sweet, the doors are open at the auto center, Canadian Tire. Maybe they can fix my light. Go in and check. Oh, no, no, we can't do that today. I don't have a license to a mechanic here. I can just do oil changes and tire changes, and that's it. I'm like, great. So I'm like, oh, okay, let's just drive her home. So I got a great big jug of juice. But before all this happened, I was so ticked off that the stupid brake line broke. I got a Canadian Tire that didn't have any auto service open. Okay, so we're going back a bit again. I get out of the truck and I had my phone in my hand, and I don't know, these things are so friggin' slippery. I haven't got a case for it yet, but good freaking thing I got the device protection on it. Yep, dropped her right on the pavement, right on that side down, smashed all the glass in the front. So yeah, I'm not too happy with that. That really pissed me off then. I was just livid then. And of course, way up there, nobody had anywhere around there on a Sunday's open that could fix a brake line for you. You know, I got all the stuff at home. I even got lines and fittings to fix my brake line, but everything was at home. So I'm like, okay, let's just drive it home. We'll park it. So that's another 2 hours home, two and half hours from Sobel area there, or yeah, from Kincardine. So it'll be another two plus the bit of, okay. So all together, let's say, and we drove all the way home again, or all the way back up to Sobel, and now we're just home again. Oh, boys, but anyways, that was one frick of a weekend, let me tell you. And you know what? The other day when I was trying those brakes on that truck, I told you, and I said something about they didn't feel right. I'm like, there isn't anything else. It's probably, I was thinking that, well, there's just a bit of air in them, right? From maybe I didn't get them quite bled out right enough, but nope. Apparently, I guess that was another brake line just starting to seep out, and then all of a sudden I pushed her down and boosh, away she went. Oh, so frustrating. And then dropping the phone, holy crap, that was the freaking icing on the cake. I was totally freaking ticked off then. But anyways, I do have device protection on that. I paid an extra $20 a month for device protection, so kind of thought when I dumped her in the pool, I might have had to use that for that, but no, it was okay, luckily. So, but this is definitely not good. You can still use it, but you got to watch you don't cut your finger and your thumb or whatever you're doing, because you can feel the sharp edges as you're swiping over and stuff. So yeah, I'll have to go over there tomorrow probably. And you think you're allowed 3 a year. So there's number one gone. God, holy geez. But anyways, I don't know, traveling and me is, all the times I traveled somewhere, most times I don't have a good time at it, you know, and I don't know, just lots of stories about that crap. Some trips have been good, but other ones are like, really? Wow. This was kind of one of them. But anyways, we made her to the races a little bit late. We got the sponsored lap in there and everything. Well, that was cool. Good to hear that. And, yeah, so, but anyways, I don't know, you may not hear much from me in a couple of days, because I got to get this crap fixed again, and I'm probably just going to pull this stupid box off of this stupid truck and do that stupid line back there, replace all that again. I won't probably film any of that. I'll just go ahead and do it and get it done, and you guys have seen, you know, me fixing brake lines and stuff and crap and stuff before, and I just don't really feel like filming that again, doing it all again. I just do it and get it done, and then that'll hopefully be friggin' it. Holy frick. And this thing, too, now, well, I think I might have mentioned it, too. It needs a tie rod end put on it there. It's got a bit of a, it's wore out, too. Frickin' parts. And that was not replaced. Might have been 2 years ago when I did the, I can't remember. I don't even remember, but my brain is so friggin' shot right now. Holy crap. I'm going to head her in and call her a day, I guess. So, yeah, like, you may not hear much from me in a couple of days. I'm just going to take her a bit easy, I think, and then we'll get back to her maybe Wednesday or something. We'll see. I don't know. I got so freaking much to do. But, anyways, have a good night, boys. Hope you enjoyed the races. At least we made her, and, you know, we actually made her for that race we were wanting to go to. So, that was good. But, anyways, have a good night. Thanks for watching. We'll catch you later.